this conference is called Decolonizing Tertiary Dance Education, A Time to Act.
And the conference really is about critically exploring, discussing and changing tertiary dance education.
It starts here. It starts with the conferences like this. And during this conference, we are going to see it in real time. People coming together, we have everybody on board.
My name is Tone Pernille Östern, and I'm in the conference committee.
And I'm Rose Martin, also on the conference committee.
My name is Alf Daniel Mabingo. I'm currently working as a lecturer of dance at Makerere University.
I think this is going to be an amazing conference, and the interest has been really big. We're going to have 64 presenters. We're going to have 4 parallel sessions almost all the time during 2 really intense days. But also we have a lot of registered participants, so we actually had to close the registration at 450 because we cannot take more than 500 on our Zoom links. We can look forward to participants and presenters really from all around the world.
Part of also what we're trying to do is unsettle how a conference is usually structured. So some of the things that possibly you could be looking forward to is a much more dialogical and conversational approach to the ideas shared in the conference. So it isn't just always sort of listening to someone talk.
So this platform is emphasizing that we should not only call professors and scholars to come and preach to the congregation that is already converted. We want to bring more people on board. And we, in this conference, we have really tried to bring people from diverse backgrounds outside academia on board because we believe they are resourceful. One of the things that I'm looking forward to during this conference is to get all these different diverse ideas, diverse practices, diverse practitioners, yeah, congregate to just share what's happening in their own context.
Entre São Tomé, Cap Vert, Afrique de l'Ouest, Lisbonne, Cadiz, Séville et les villes portuaires d'Amérique, tous les Noirs de Séville étaient donc obligés par l'Église de participer comme musiciens aux fêtes de la Vierge.
Ce que l'historien mexicain Garcia de León a nommé le Caribe afro-andalou.
Une zone culturelle de 500 ans.
The conference comes at a time when the world is undergoing very, very significant changes. If we look at Black Lives Matter, for example, in North America, but also a movement that has captured the energy and the imagination of communities in Europe, here on the African continent, in Oceania and other parts of the world, and the issues. Because for us, the issues are very important that are being fronted through some of these kinds of movements. We felt that it is necessary to start a conversation.
I think it's important for us to know here in the Nordic countries that really this shift has been going on at other universities and in other countries for a much longer time, like for example at Makerere University, but also at Auckland University in New Zealand, where they have been grappling with the colonial heritage in a much more substantial and clearer way. We also have our own colonial history in these countries. And talking about that, I would like to mention maybe that one of our keynotes will be Ola Stinnebom, who is from Sápmi, or the indigenous Sami Sweden. And I don't know if that has ever happened before, actually, that we have a keynote speaker from Sápmi in a dance educational conference.
Jag heter Ola Stinnebom. Jag är dansare, koreograf, musiker, jojkare, slöjdare, forskare, skriver böcker. Ja. Jag håller på med väldigt mycket. Mitt deltagande i konferensen handlar om mitt forskningsarbete om den samiska dansen. generellt så är det ett arbete som är väldigt kontroversiellt. Eftersom alla forskare och även alla samer är överens om att samerna har aldrig dansat. Och det är en ganska märklig tes, tycker jag. För att om det skulle vara så att samerna skulle vara det enda folket i hela världen som inte dansar, vad är det för fel på samerna i så fall? Staten har ju drivit ett extremt hårt förtryck mot samerna. De har pågått i århundraden med en enorm försvenskningspolitik. Och tillsammans med kyrkan så redan på 1600-talet så bestämde man att stora delar av den samiska kulturen jämställdes med djävulen och satanism. Det infördes en tystnad, en slags tystnadskultur över de gamla ritualerna, de gamla riterna om dansen och trumman och jojken och hur det såg ut. Och därför är det inte så konstigt att man inte pratar om det, för det är ingen som vet. Målet med mitt arbete det är ju att försöka att ta tillbaka kulturarvet och levandegöra det. Men jag vill inte ta tillbaka det i ett historiskt eller ett musealt perspektiv. Utan det finns ju väldigt många tomma hålrum i mitt forskningsmaterial. Och de vill jag fylla in med trovärdiga beståndsdelar då. Och i ett möte med den samiska publiken, vid ett samtal efter att man har dansat, så tror jag att man så småningom kan hitta någonting, vad som kan upplevas som samiskt och vad som kan kännas samiskt.
This conference in a Nordic context is only a beginning. It's only an opening. It by no means can mean that we are ticking a box. This is just the start, and this has to be an ongoing issue for us to experience a much more a richer dance educational and arts educational world, which is also based on equity in a completely new way.
So we think and believe that if we want to see the world change in a positive direction, especially with all these issues that are coming up about race, issues about culture, issues about xenophobia, issues about conflict, issues about migration, voluntarily and forced, we felt that this conference, which is the first of its kind, will be a very good starting point in terms of bringing people together to have a conversation, but also brainstorm on some visible, tangible, practical actions that can be taken within the parameters of fire institutions, but also beyond in the communities.
We're really excited that the universities that are involved in this first conference, they are keen to continue this work. So they have already decided that they will take on the conference every second year. So I think we have at least maybe the five next or something.
I think so. We obviously have Makarere University being our host for the next conference.
Yes, 2024.
Yeah.
This conference will happen at Makarere University.
Normally what happens is that conferences happen, and then at the end of the conference, people go back, and sometimes they don't happen again. Or sometimes they happen again, and then they are about totally different things. What we are looking for here in proposing some biennial, ever after 2 years conference, is the idea of consistency, but also the idea of accountability. So that when we have a conference, for example, this year, and we share ideas and talk about actions that need to be taken, we have follow-up conferences to check in and see where are we, what have people done, how can we learn from one another, how can we improve,